Good morning, students. Let's begin with part 2, chapter 15, Some Natural Phenomena, class 8, subject science. You can see the lightning, tsunamis and the earthquake image here. Let's talk more about them in detail. A natural phenomena is not a man-made event. Example include sunrise, weather, biological process, physical process, tidal flow, and include natural disasters such as electromagnetic pulse, volcanic eruption, and earthquakes. Lightning is the strikes of bright light and sound caused by the electric discharge between the cloud and the earth over or between the different clouds. Some object can be charged by rubbing with the other objects. When objects are rubbed, they attract the light objects because they gain some electrostatic force. This process is called the charging by the friction. A plastic refill scale comes when rubbed with the dry hair, paper or polythene gets charged and attracts the pieces of small paper. The charge acquired by rubbing are static charges. They do not move. When charge move, it is called the electrical current. Electric current is motion of charge through the conductor. This activity we all have performed. Types of charge and their interactions. There are two types of charge. They are positive charge and negative charge. Two charges body may attract or repel with each other. Similar charge repel with each other and unlike charge attract to each other. Inflate two balloons, hang them in such a way that they do not touch each other. Rub both the balloons with the woolen clothes and release them. You will observe they start repelling with each other because they both had same kind of charge. Now let us repeat the activity with the use of pen refills. Rub one refill with the polythene. Place it carefully in a glass tumbler using tumbler as a stand. Rub the other refill with the polythene. Bring it close together, the refill. Be careful not to touch the charge end with your end. Is there any effect on the refill in the tumbler? Do two attract each other or repel? Yes, they do repel with each other as there is a similar kind of charge acquired by the refills. Now rub a refill and place it gently in the glass tumbler as before. Bring an inflated charge balloon near the refill and observe. You will see that unlike charge attracts each other. What we have observed? A charge balloon repel a charge balloon. Charge refill repel a charge refill. But a charge balloon attract the charge refill because of the different charges obtained by them. This is the electroscope. You can see the metallic disc at the top and aluminium foil at the end. An electroscope is a device used to test whether an object having electric charge or not. A simple electroscope can be made by using empty bottles, a piece of cardboard, a paper clip, two small strips of aluminium. Pass one end of the paper clip through the cardboard and hung the two aluminium strips from another end. If a charged body is touched to the end of the paper clip, the aluminium strips repel with each other. You can see that this way you can find out whether the object holded by you is carrying any charge or not. How to do transfer of charge? When a charged body is brought in contact with the uncharged body, pass from the charged body to the uncharged body. This method of charging body is called the charging contact or the conduction. If a body is charged by the contact, it gets the same charge as the charged body. We can observe the transfer of charge by using electroscope. The charges are transferred to the metal strips and they repel with each other. This is because both the metal strips get the same charge and they repel with each other. Electric discharge. If we touch a charged electroscope with our hand, the charge passes through our body to the earth and the metal strips collapse. This property is called the electric discharge. The process of transferring electric charges from the charged body to the earth is called the earthing. Earthing is provided in the building to protect us from the electric shock due to the leakage of electric current. What is lightning? During thunderstorm, air current moves upward and water droplets move downwards. This movement causes the separation of charge in the clouds. The positive charge collected at the upper part and the negative charge collected at the lower part of the clouds. Some negative charge collect near the ground also, and when large amount of charge is formed, then the charge passes from the clouds to the earth, producing streak of light and the sound. The light produced is called lightning and sound produced is called the thunder. It was Benjamin Franklin who first discovered the lightning as the electric discharge. Lightning conductor is a device used to protect the tall building from the damage to the light. A lightning conductor has the metallic rod. The upper end is pointed and the lower end is joined to the metal plate buried instead in the ground. When lightning strikes, the electric charge passes through it to the earth without causing any damage to the building. You can see how these plates are placed underground. Protection of lightning and thunderstorm. If you are outdoor, open vehicles like motorbike, truck, open cars not safe. Open field, parks, elevated place, tall trees are not safe. Carrying an umbrella is not safe. If in a forest, take shelter under short tree. If in an open field or stay away from the trees, poles, metallic objects, do not lie down. Square on the ground with the hands on the knees and head between the hands. If you are inside the house, lightning can strike electric wires, telephone cords and metal pipes to connect with this object should be avoided. It is safer to use mobile and cordless phone than the wire phones. Electric appliances like TV, computer, etc. should be unplugged. Bathing should be avoided to avoid the contact with runny water. Earthquake. An earthquake is sudden shocking or the trembling of the earth caused by the disturbance deep inside the earth's core. Earthquake cause damage to the building, dams, bridges. It can also cause the landslides, floods, tsunamis. It can also cause the damage to the life and the property. What causes an earthquake? The outermost layer of earth crust is not one piece. It is fragmented in many plates. These plates are moving continuously. When these plates brush apart, when one plate goes another plate due to collision, they cause the disturbance and cause the earthquake. The boundaries of plates are the weak zones or called the seismic zones. The earthquake often occurs in the seismic zones. You can see how is the figure and outer zones and the inner zones and the crust are there and how the earthquake is going to take place between the seismic zones. The seismic zone in India are Kashmir, Himalaya, Northeastern region, Kutch, Rajasthan, Andaman and Nicobar Islet, and some region of South India as well. The power of an earthquake is measured on the scale called Richter scale. Very destructive earthquakes have magnitudes more than 7.5 on Richter scale. The earthquake produces waves on the surface of earth called the seismic waves. Seismic waves are recorded by the instrument called seismograph. These are the seismic zones shown in the figure. Protection from the earthquake. The buildings in the seismic zone should be designed such that they can withstand the tremor due to earthquake. Materials like mud, wood, light roof should be used instead of heavy materials. Heavy objects like cupboards, water heaters, etc. should not be fixed on the walls. All buildings should have the firefighting equipment. Precautions during earthquake. If you are at home, take a shelter under table. If you are in a bed, do not get up. Protect your head with pillow. Stay away from tall and heavy objects which may fall on you. If you are outdoors, find an open area away from the buildings. trees and the power lines and lying on the grounds. If you are in a car or a bus, ask the drivers to slow down and do not get out till the tremors stop. Seismograph. An earthquake generates the seismic waves which can be detected with the sensitive instruments called the seismograph. Advanced seismograph technology have increased our understanding of both earthquakes and the earth itself. Perhaps the earliest seismograph was invented in China, that is AD 136, by a name called Coco. This is the basic instrument, how the seismograph does look, and it creates the image in the form of waves. I hope this chapter was much clearer to you. You can read the exercise, you can read the chapter and perform the exercise. I'll see you with the next videos. Bye-bye.